Trends we're seeing in, so I focus in particular on the trends in Europe. And one of the things that we've seen as the European Union looks at online content issues is a trend towards, one, wanting to mandate filtering, so to kind of mandate that companies sort of try to preemptively or proactively remove what might be illegal content, which raises a number of concerns because many different types of filtering are notoriously overbroad. And there's also a real focus around kind of timeframes and wanting companies to take content down, you know, within very short timeframes of being notified about it, which again, from it's, you know, it often comes up in the context of concerns about terrorist propaganda in particular, or hate speech or maybe incitement to violence. And it's from the kind of the public policy side, understandable to think like, okay, a quick response is really warranted. And, you know, if you see content that is proposing an imminent attack, yes, that is the sort of thing that seems like a quick response is really warranted. But to sort of treat all content that might be, you know, even just kind of generic propaganda about, you know, a terrorist organization or, you know, or a hateful ideal, to say that there's a kind of a rational reason why that needs to come down in 24 hours or 8 hours or even the latest in the terrorist content regulation in Europe is a 1 hour removal time period. It absolutely tilts the balance completely on the side of rapid takedown without evaluation really of the content or the context in which it's posted, or any kind of consideration of is there some legitimate reason that this person is sharing this material that maybe isn't immediately apparent on its face. So it really tilts the scales in the side of takedown without question, as opposed to giving intermediaries the breathing room to have emergency responses in circumstances where an emergency is clearly evident, but also to be thoughtful about things like videos documenting war crimes in Syria, where you have some really horrific material that was produced in the context of terrorist activity, but is actually, you know, being stored on YouTube as a way to document crimes, not to support them.